Good morning, students. Welcome to the virtual class. We are studying chapter number 7, chemical equilibrium. In our last lecture, we discussed related to the heterogeneous equilibrium. Today, we will understand it that when chemical equilibrium is established, how can we predict the equilibrium condition? So we are having it as a, suppose we are having it as a reaction A plus B, it gets converted into C plus D. I want to know it that at what condition this equilibrium will be established. Where the equilibrium will be in the, when most of the reaction is completed. The reason is, when we are talking about the equilibrium, equilibrium does not mean that when the 50% of the reaction is completed in the product, it's an equilibrium. It's not necessary. Equilibrium can be established after 5%, 10%, 20%, 50%, 70%, 90% reaction is completed, equilibrium may be established. So, the condition when the equilibrium will be established or whether the reaction is under equilibrium condition or not, that can be predicted by some method. We are having some specific rules through which we can see it. Particularly when we are writing an equilibrium, what we are indicating is a concentration of product upon reactant. So what does this show? If the concentration of the product is much more, very high, then what will happen? The denominator is less, so overall answer we are going to get it as more. So if concentration of products are higher, the value of Kc can be higher. Right, but how to predict it? What are the rules? So we are having it as a the method predicting up to what extent, whether the reaction will be, suppose if I am putting in one reaction and saying it 10%, 20%, 30% or 50% or 90% is completed. Is it necessary that the equilibrium is established? We don't know, but by the value of K, we can predict it that whether the reaction has attained the equilibrium, whether it's towards the equilibrium or it has crossed the equilibrium. Right? If I put it like this, as a number line that you are doing it, in the similar way I am putting number line. I am putting here. Suppose this is the condition where the equilibrium is there. Right? I have started the reaction. Reaction is started. It's proceeding. And at this condition, at this particular point, if I ask you whether the reaction is in forward direction, whether the reaction will proceed in reverse direction to attain the equilibrium, or whether the reaction is at equilibrium, then what we can say is this particular point, it's showing me that it has not yet reached equilibrium. So what will happen to attain the equilibrium? The reaction will move in the forward direction. Suppose the question was asked to you at this point, then what will happen? This point has already crossed the equilibrium. The reaction is proceeding further. And then if I say that, if I stop, if I do stop the reaction or provide the condition for the reaction, what will happen? How will it attain the equilibrium? By proceeding in the further direction or by going in for the reverse? So what will be the other answer? As it has crossed the equilibrium, it will go for reverse direction. Right? If it has been asked at this particular point, then what we can say? Reaction is at equilibrium. But how to predict this? How to know it? So for that case, we are having it as a, the first point, we are having it as different conditions or different ways we can calculate it. Right? So the first one that we put it, prediction. Predicting the extent of equilibrium. Right? Predicting the extension of equilibrium. Now in that case, what the extent we will be getting? So for it, the first point is, if k is 10 raised to 3, kc value or k equilibrium, the equilibrium condition, if I am getting that equilibrium as 10 raised to 3, then what will happen? The reaction shows equilibrium which has proceeded, it has extended, right? The reaction shows equilibrium is attained after majority of reaction is completed. Majority of the reaction has been completed. That means you can say that here product is more, reactant is left out is very very less, right? So that means the reaction will be nearly to completion, right? You can say that it's a reaction, majority of the reaction is completed. That is, product is more and reactant left in reaction is less. Or in other words, you can say that reaction has completed more than 70% of the reaction has been completed, right? Or you can say that as we just a moment ago we saw it, this was equilibrium condition, right? If this is the reaction, then this would be the equilibrium condition will be attained after 70% of the reaction. More than 70% would have crossed. And if I am proceeding further, then if the value is even higher than this, then what will happen? Reaction will try to go for backward direction, for the reverse reaction, right? So in that case, we will be getting it as a reaction trying to come for reverse condition. Now in place of that, if we are having it as a, if kc is equal to 10 raised to minus 3, if kc is less than greater than, because it's not fixed, less than or greater than, and in this condition, if kc is 10 raised to less than 10 raised to minus 3, the reaction shows equilibrium is attained after uniform amount of reactive used, or the minimum amount of the reactant is used. That means you can say that after 10%, 20% reactant is used, reaction will attain equilibrium, right? So a very small quantity of the reaction has been processed. So here you can say that reactant is greater. Reactant has greater concentration than product. During the equilibrium, reactant will be less, reactant will be more, product will be less, right? You can say that this is less than 30%. Less than 30% reaction has been completed and the equilibrium is attained. And the third condition that you can put it in it, that is, now in between 10 raised to 3 and 10 raised to minus 3, if EC is between 10 raised to minus 3 to minus 15. While identifying the value of it, EC is equal to 10 raised to minus 3 to 10 raised to 3, then the equilibrium has, then we can say that the equilibrium has almost same concentration of real fat and product. That means you can say that reaction is 32-70%. It's between 32-70%, right? If it is 50%, you can say that equal concentration of it, reactant and product are there, 40, maybe 45, maybe 50, 60, like that, the concentration may vary. And accordingly, we will be getting the answer that whether the reaction has more amount of the reaction is completed, less is completed, or is it equally or almost equally completed, right? So that is up to the extent of the equilibrium that we have indicated. Now, if the extent is known to me and I want to know the direction, the second thing is if I want to know it in which direction the reaction will proceed, then how can I come to know it that in which direction these reactions will proceed? So for that case, what we will do, we need to find out the equilibrium. Before entering the equilibrium, we need to calculate the reaction quotient. Reaction. Quotient. Now what does it indicate? It's also indicated by QC. Reaction quotient. Now what this indicates? How much reaction has been completed? Now equilibrium condition is going to give me, and then it's told to me that how much reaction is completed, whether it is crossed equilibrium or before equilibrium. So what we say, if QC is less than TC, right? If QC is less than KC, then reaction has not attained equilibrium, hence it will try to attain equilibrium by proceeding in forward direction. It will try to proceed in forward direction. That means you can say that reactant will try to get converted into product. So more amount of the reaction will be proceeded. Forward reaction takes place. Right? Okay. The second condition, that is, if QC is greater than KC, then reaction is it will try
2 again equilibrium by proceeding backward. Please also know that reverse direction by moving it in the from reactant to product in case of that equilibrium from product to reactant. Right? And the third condition that is QCVD equals to TC. The third condition we get is if QCVD, then reaction has attained equilibrium. Then reaction is in equilibrium. Hence, no further reaction, no reaction takes place. It has already attained the equilibrium, so it will remain stable. No reactant will get converted into product or product will get converted into reactant. Right? So that is the way how can we predict it, whether it will go for forward, reverse, whether it is more or less or 50% earlier. How can we predict it? Right? And the third condition is, how can we calculate this equilibrium? Now, when we have been given out such kind of a numericals, how can I calculate the equilibrium? So third point that I have to discuss is how to calculate now when we are talking about how to calculate the equilibrium constant, then for this it will be necessary that we should know it step by step. All the calculations will be done and a table has to be prepared. In our very first point, for this will be write the balance the reaction. It's a very first important point. We should write the balance the reaction. If your reaction is not balanced, then also the equilibrium constant won't be able to calculate or predict it correctly. So it is necessary that first point, whenever I want to go for any kind of calculations, first point is balanced chemical reaction. Then the second point, the table has to be prepared in which whatever I would write it is, I should know initial concentration, right? I will have to write the initial concentration. For that case, if I say that my balanced reaction is A plus B getting converted into C plus D, right? This is suppose my balanced reaction, and it is told to me that reactants are there, one mole of each. If it is told to me, one mole, then I will take it as one mole as a whole. If it is told to me A moles, B moles, then I will take it as an A and B, right? Moles. But at that time, the product is not there. If it is told to me that the product is also there, then accordingly that much product I should take it, right? But for example, I have told that here we are having A moles of A and B moles of B. If you have been given the sum and it is told to me that 2 moles and 3 moles are there, I should have taken 2 moles and 3 moles. Right? So that is our first initial concentration should be known. Then used, how much quantity of the product reactant has been used up or reacted. Used up, you can see it as reacted quantity. How much quantity has been used up? Generally, at present what we say, X is used. Now, if it is told to me that X moles of A is used, then what does the reaction show? If this is 1 mole, this is 1 mole. If this is x moles, how much will be used? X. Right? Similarly, it is told to me that if this is 1 mole, this is 1 mole produced. So if this is x is used, how much will be used? Produced? X will be produced. Same way. So we will be getting it as an x moles. So what is the concentration and equilibrium? We will be having it as an A minus X, B minus X, this one will be X. Suppose it was given to me, then it would be a plus. That much quantity would have been plus. Right? If it is told to be C, then I would have got it as C plus X. If this is told to me as D, then I would have got D plus X. So products will be added, reactants will be subtracted. That you have to remember, products will be always added, reactants will be subtracted, right? But this is an equilibrium, and when we want to calculate it, we need the equilibrium constant to be calculated. Reactants and products are taken in the terms of moles per liter, right? So concentration in terms of moles per liter. So whatever the quantity is given to you, we will be dividing it by the volume. So that means it will give me the unit in the terms of moles per liter. Once I get this, that is, this is what I have to prepare the table. If I made an error in writing the balance reaction, there would be a possibility that I would have got this something different. Right? So after that, what we do is putting the well-known equation of
into PC.
CCl3 and CCl2.
Similar type of other sums also, we will make it as a practice.
theory that we wrote it, right? How to make the calculation, how to make the table, how to prepare it. This is the one example that we did. We will, in our next lecture, we will do it as an another numericals also, right? Till then, thank you.